Hello, welcome again. We are solving IIT JEE Physics. Topic is kinematics. Question number 20 is, a particle moves from the point 2.0 I plus 4.0 J meter at t is equal to 0 with an initial velocity 5.0 I plus 4.0 J meter per second. It is acted upon by a constant force which produces a constant acceleration 4.0 I plus 4.0 J meter per second square. What is the distance of the particle from the origin at time 2 seconds? Options: 1. 20 root 2 meter, 2. 15 meter, 3. 10 root 2 meter, 4. 5 meter. Okay. So ux is your ux initial velocity in x direction is 5 and in y direction is 4 and acceleration in x direction is 4 and in acceleration in y direction is 4. Okay, so this is your 5 and 4, this is 4 and 5. Okay. Now this is the initial point from where it is started. So x coordinate initially is 2 and y coordinate initially is 4. So the distance travel from in x and y direction can be found from this ux ax and uy ay. So sx is your u into in 2 seconds. So s using s is equal to ut plus half a t square. So sx will be your 5 into 2 plus 1 by 2 4 into 2 square 18 meter. And similarly sy is your 4 into 2 plus half into 4 into 2 square, that is 16 meter. Okay, so this is the distance travel, and initial point is your 2 and 4, 2 in x and 4 in y. So the next new coordinate are 2 plus 8 is 20, and final y coordinate is 4 plus 16, that is 20. So distance from origin is your 20 square plus 20 square, that is 20 root 2. So option 1 is the right answer. Next. A passenger train of length 60 meter travels at a speed of 80 km per hour. Another freight train of length 120 meter travels at a speed of 30 km per hour. The ratio of times taken by a passenger train to completely cross the freight train when they are moving in the same direction and two in the opposite direction. Options: 1. 25 by 11, 2. 11 by 5, 3. 5 by 2, 4. 3 by 2. Okay. When they are moving in same direction, the speed is, when they are moving in same direction, then the relative speed will be distance of 2. Okay. So the speed of passenger train is 80, and passenger speed of freight train is 30. So the relative velocity is here 80 minus 30 is 50 meter kilometer per hour. Okay. And the distance traveled in will be the summation of the length of two trains. Okay, that will be 120 meter plus 60 meter. Okay. So this is 180 meter. So and now the relative speed is 50 kilometer per hour. So we can find out time. Time is distance by speed, that is 180 by 50. Okay, so that is 180 by 50. Okay, when they are moving in opposite direction, then the speed will be added. Relative speed will be 80 by 30, that is 110 km per hour. Okay, so distance travel will be 180 meters same. Because they have to completely cross each other, so distance will be 180 meters, and the time will be your 180 by 110. So that will be your. So the, we have to find out the ratio of the time. Okay, when they are moving in same direction, when they are moving in same opposite direction, so T1 is 180 by 50. And this is your 110 by 80. So answer will be 11 by 5. So the answer is option 2, 11 by 5. Okay. Next. Two particles A and B आर मूविंग ऑन टू कॉन्सेंट्रिक सर्कल ऑफ रेडियस आर वन एंड आर टू विद इक्वल एंगुलर स्पीड ओमेगा एट टी इज इक्वल जीरो. देयर पोजिशन एंड डायरेक्शन ऑफ मोशन आर शोन इन फिगर. द रिलेटिव वेलोसिटी वी ए माइनस वी बी एट टी इज इक्वल टू पाई बाय टू ओमेगा इज गिवन बाय वन ओमेगा आर वन माइनस आर टू आई टू ओमेगा आर टू माइनस आर वन आई थ्री माइनस ओमेगा आर वन प्लस आर टू आई फोर ओमेगा आर वन प्लस आर टू आई. सो हेयर द स्पीड दिस इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ पार्टिकल ए एंड दिस इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ पार्टिकल बी एंड द टाइम इज हियर पाई बाय टू ओमेगा टी इज हियर पाई बाय टू ओमेगा. ओके सो एंगुलर वेलोसिटी इज हियर so time is so angular velocity will be your as angular velocity is 2 pi by time period where small t is your time given and t is your time period. Okay so angular velocity is by putting the value of omega here we can find out t. So t is your capital T by 4. Okay so this is your t by 4 time period. Okay so this is the time to complete one revolution. Okay so in t is the time when to complete one revolution. So in time t by 4 only one quarter of revolution will be completed and the angle will be pi by 2 or 90 degrees. Okay so after now the starting point of this a is this point and starting point of b is this point. So after time t by 4 there is this particle will be at this point and the particle b will be at this point. Okay so the velocity of particle a will be in this direction and velocity of particle b will be in this direction. Okay so this will be your v a relative velocity will be you have to find out relative velocity. Okay relative velocity will be as velocity are in same direction. So relative velocity will be difference of two. So V A minus V B will be omega R one, which is in negative direction, which is in this direction, omega minus omega R one, and this is also in negative direction. Okay. So we will add here because we have to subtract this velocity to find out relative velocity. So V A minus V B will be your minus omega R one. Plus omega r2 in positive x direction. That means I is here. So this will be omega r2 minus r1 I. So option 2 is the right answer.